guys,
right before we go into the room of the Last Supper, I want to go with you back to the days of Jesus. Jesus is coming here from the Galilee. He's a villager. He's a common person who's going and preaching between the common persons. He never been to Jerusalem. He's got the vision how Jerusalem should look like. And he was, I remember, very, very strict, very, very religious. Now, he's coming here not in a normal day. He's coming in Passover. There's three holidays that Jewish are celebrating, that people coming from all over the world to celebrate in Jerusalem. Pilgrim into the temple. One of them is Passover. Imagine you're hosting the Mundial Games in your city, the Olympic Games, okay? People from all over the world. Jesus is coming here and he's completely shocked. Let's go closer so we let if other groups come behind us. You can come next to me so they will follow our back. Yeah? Now, he's coming here and he's shocked, and the first thing that he sees, the people exchanging money right next to the temple. Why you exchange money? Why you have a market? Why you need to buy and sell? He doesn't understand because he is a villager. Imagine a guy that coming to the first time in his life to Manhattan. You are shocked. Now, you have to exchange the coins because in the ancient days, on every coin, there is the face of the emperor. So you cannot allow to bring an image. This is the second commandment of the Ten Commandments we're going to talk about. He sees that and he turns the table. Now, there's Romans, there's Jewish, you know, he's going against the Roman way, he's going against the Jewish, they're following the Roman ways. But if you're a Roman Caesar or a Roman ruler, and you see a guy that leading 300 people coming in the most delicate time in the year and start to make riots, more than that. Someone is whispering on the ear of the Caesar, Pontius Pilate, this guy says that he's the king. King? This one, the Caesar. If you do something that is different than that, you're taking a risk. And in Romans, mostly Pontius Pilate doesn't take any risks. You can have evidence that people that you had, miles of people crossed on the way to Jerusalem. Don't mess with me. I don't have time to live with you. And this is what happens. He says, okay, it's a holiday. We're not going to catch him now. We let him celebrate the holiday, the Passover, over here. And this is when he's gathering all the apostles. And he knows that his hours are numbered. And he's getting them together. We're going to go inside and see what's going on in this ceremony, on the Eucharist, on the Last Supper.